So I remember 3 months after starting YouTube, I sent this company an email saying, can I review one of your slides? I don't need to keep it. I'll send it back to you. And I'll never forget, like, they were very reluctant, but then... they went ahead and sent me a slide. I did the review, I sent it back. I've done many reviews for them ever since. And we've done reviews for their Glock 19 slides, Glock 17 slides, all kinds of stuff. But today, we're gonna be taking a look at the Norsso Glock 26 Reptile. So this slide, you know, kind of holds a special place in my heart because, hey, you know, there's something to be said to somebody when they take a chance with you and they didn't even need to. The reason I bring that up is, yeah, I might be a little bit biased towards them, so keep that in mind. Take this review as a grain of salt. You know, don't take my word for it. Do some of your own research on the side. For this, if this is something that you guys want to take a look at, just check the first link in the description. It'll take you to a page with all the product links. Norsso created the Reptile slide a little over a year ago, and they essentially wanted it to look like the scales of a reptile, which is dead sexy. Don't worry, we'll dive up close here in a second and take a look at it. Well, they finally came out with one for the Glock 26. But what's interesting about Norsso is they're not the kind of company that you send your slides to and have them cut. You just buy the slides from them, and I think they just got a fresh restock of these slides. They were out of stock for a little while after Black Friday, but I just talked to him the other night and he said they got a fresh stock in. Hopefully those are still there, but you guys know how these videos go. Sometimes I post a video and things are gone in 10 minutes, and sometimes it might take a day or two. That's just the nature of the game, I guess. But I got it topped off on my Polymer 80 build right here. This is the one I did from XL Weapon Works. I have the SSVI trigger in it, as well as the Barracuda Tactical Mag Extension, and we got the Railmaster Pro weapon light on it. It's not the greatest weapon light in the world. I've done a video on it in the past. I'll put a link below if you want to watch that video. With all that being said, let's take a look at it in all its glory. Talk about some of the tech specs and this interesting coating that it has on it. It's a very different coating than what we've been seeing on any other slides. Then we're gonna go over the range footage, talk about if we had any issues with it cycling or anything like that. Then we're gonna talk about what my final opinion is. Knowing what I know now, would I buy it or not? All right, guys, so here we are up close in all its glory with the Norsso Reptile for the Glock 26. Now, one interesting thing, if you guys are new to my Glock 26 builds that I've been doing, interesting thing about Glock 26 is their Gen 3 and Gen 4 slides are identical. So they are both backwards and forwards compatible. They both use this same recoil system right here. So Gen 3 and Gen 4 slides will fit on Gen 3 or Gen 4 frames, which the reason I bring that up is Polymer 80 frames are based around Gen 3. So it doesn't matter if you have a Gen 4 slide, it's gonna work. Let's take a look at where it all started. This was the original Reptile slide right here. They did this on an OEM style where it already had the rear serrations in place. You can see right here, this one was milled to have a red dot, so you won't see any serrations there. But comparing it to the new one, let me show you. The only real difference is because it's a shorter slide, your window is gonna be a little bit smaller and you're gonna get one less serration on the front. But on the rear here, now because they manufacture their own slides, they will put these really nice, grippy, slanted rear serrations on it as well. On the sides, they do their logos very, very tastefully. They're very small. You guys know that's something that bothers me when a company just stamps a sign on the side of their slide. But aside from that, the only other difference is the coating. On the right, this is a standard black nitride, and on the left is what they call their battle-hardened nitride. And it's essentially kind of has like a, it kind of reminds me of a copper penny after it ages a little bit. On all the sharp edges of the slide, it's a little bit, looks like it's a little bit battle-worn, like it's shining through. I don't know how to explain it, but you can definitely see it here on camera. You can see why it's called the Reptile. I mean, look at the top, it looks like scales. The sides, they look like scales. What's cool about it though is here, we can grip it really nicely up here. We can grip it really nicely back here or back here. So that's kind of cool. So I already know a lot of you guys are gonna ask. We got it on the Polymer 80 frame. This one is from XL Weapon Works. I got the SSVI trigger in it. Got the Barracuda Mag Extensions, and I got the Blacklist Industries barrel. 4 Glock 26s in it, got OEM sights, and we're using this Railmaster Pro weapon light that I modified to fit the Polymer 80 Glock 26 frames. I have a video about the light. If that's something you're interested in, I'll put a link below. So let's take it apart and see how it's wearing. Now, I really like testing with these Blacklist Industries barrels. Now, this barrel, I've had it for over a year, and it's ran really great. I mean, I've beat the crap out of this barrel. But the reason I like testing with it is because they have really tight tolerances on their barrels. And their barrels do have a little bit of a break-in period. Not all the time, but sometimes. As you can see right here on this barrel hood up here, it had a little bit of a break-in period there. And that can show me, you know, how tight the tolerances are on the slide. So on the inside here, I'm not seeing too much wear. Let me see if I can get some light on it. Down in the rails, I'm not seeing too much. Down in this side, not too much. We always are gonna get wear right here on this ramp, but that's to be expected. And down here in the front, not too much either. I think right now we're at 250, maybe 240 rounds. I think one of my boxes wasn't full of ammo. But that's what it looks like up close. Let's jump up top. Let's talk about the coupon codes, the pros and the cons, and what I think about it so far. Back up top. So that is the Norsso Reptile. Couple things that we should know about this one right off the bat is, number one, this is a slide that you buy from them directly. You don't send in your slide to have it done. So the price includes the cost of the slide, as well as the slide cuts, and the battle-hardened nitride. And you saw that up close. It's a nitride coating, which for those of you who are new, nitride is one of the toughest coatings that you can get on a slide. It's basically, it's the most similar to the OEM coatings that come on Glocks or M&Ps. I mean, they use different names for their stuff, and there's a little bit different properties to theirs, but nitride is most definitely one of the toughest coatings ever. So the price includes all of that. We'll talk about the price here in a second. First, let's talk about how it performed at the range. So I took this out to the range on the Polymer 80 frame and put some rounds through it. So I put a few mags through it, didn't have any hiccups. I was using 115 grain, both aluminum and brass cased ammo. I think some of it was CCI and some of it was Federal. No issues. And I like using that kind of ammo when I'm doing tests for a product, because I know for a fact then my OEM Glocks will shoot that stuff no problem. And the reason I like testing with low powered ammo like that, or cheap ammo, is because I know if it will function with that, it will most definitely function with the higher powered ammo, like your Plus P's, or your like your Hornady critical duty, critical defense type ammo. It'll definitely function with that. And that's something that I always test for. It passed that test. Then I put some more rounds through it. And again, it cycled very, very well. The cool thing about this nitride coating is, I don't know if you guys remember, but we did a video on the titanium nitride in Glock 26 slide a couple of weeks ago.
Okay, so it didn't have a stovepipe, but I don't think it loaded another round. Okay. We were doing pretty good there for a second.
And with that one, I had a feeling, even before I shot it, I just could just tell by the way it felt in my hand that it was gonna have some cycling issues and was gonna have a break-in period. Now, titanium nitride, because that one wasn't polished in the rails, that's why I knew that. Now, the standard nitride, or the battle-hardened nitride, is way more slippery. It requires way less lubrication. Because it has less friction, it will produce less heat and it will be less wear on your parts. So no issues with cycling at all. Zero malfunctions regardless if I use this mag or a flush fit Glock 26 mag. As far as the way the serrations feel in the hand, you can press check it, no problems. That's not an issue at all. Also on the rear back here, these serrations catch really well. And even on the top serrations back here, you know, you can really get your finger in there and just pull them down. I like that a lot. Another cool thing about it is, yeah, I mean, I got stock sights on this right now. You can kind of catch them. They will even catch in your belt a little bit. So that's kind of nice to have. So all in all, I mean, I gotta give this a win because one, I didn't have any types of malfunctions with it. It's priced right. I think they're around $400-ish. You have to check them in the description, but it will come out lower than what you see on their website. But that's the price of the slide, the price of the slide cuts, as well as the battle hardened nitride coating. You know, that's always cool. But overall, it's a win. You know, it's not wearing too bad on the inside and you don't need a whole lot of lubrication to let it run, and it runs flawlessly. Maybe I'm a little biased, maybe I'm not, but I'm only reporting what I experienced. You know, if it would have had a malfunction, I would have told you guys, regardless of how I feel towards a company. So just keep that in mind. I do tell these companies, hey, you're my friend, or maybe they're not my friend. I just tell them every time. If it falls apart, malfunctions, it's going on camera, guys. Hit that little subscribe button down below if you guys are interested, if that's something you're into. If not, that's cool too. I'm not here to judge you. But until next time, guys, you stay sexy, and I love you.